With so many cars available in Gran Turismo 7 and so many parts and paint shop items to pay for, managing your credits in the game is a top priority. Of course, you can buy credits with real money from the PlayStation Store, but they are very expensive. So finding the fastest ways to earn free credits within the game itself is more important than ever. To help you out, we have dug through GT7 to find the very best ways to fatten up your wallet. Although some of the suggestions here will earn significantly more credits than others, some take more time, and others are not accessible until you are farther along in the game. For all the events, as a general rule, you should downgrade the overall game difficulty to easy through your options menu in order to make the AI less of an obstacle to your time. Earning the 50% clean race bonus is also vital to maximize your earnings. Of course, these are the best methods as of GT7's launch in March of 2022. To check for any updates or new events added to the game later, check out the related article on our website via the link in the video description below. We will keep that up to date with any new tricks or methods as they arrive. All right, let's get started. First up is the American Clubman Cup 700 at Special Stage Route X, which will earn you around 600,000 credits per hour. If you're searching for a truly brain-dead method of earning quick credits, this is the one for you. Once you've unlocked the massive Special Stage Route X Oval with Menu Book 26, this event becomes available and it is a walk in the park. Although the name of the series suggests you'll need a 700 PP car, there is in fact no performance point limit. That means you can go crazy with upgrades if you want, and the 4 GT you'll win from Menu Book 26 will be a perfect fit for this event. It's a single lap race, but there's pretty much nothing to it. Once you blast past the AI, it's essentially 4 lonely minutes at max throttle. That's worth 45,000 credits with the clean race bonus, which is a nice round 10,000 credits per minute, though you may fall asleep in the process. Next up is the American FR Challenge 550 at Blue Moon Bay, also good for 600,000 credits per hour. After being the money-making race of choice in GT Sport, exploiting Blue Moon Bay Speedway is back in GT7. The American FR Challenge unlocks at Menu Book 13, much earlier than the previously mentioned Special Stage Route X event, and it doesn't take as long either. It's worth 22,500 credits with a surprisingly robust clean race bonus. There are some restrictions here, as you'll need a front-engined American road car with rear-wheel drivetrain. However, you can shove as many performance points as you want into the car and slap on racing tires if you really want to go all out. You can be done with the 3-lap race in just over 2 minutes, earning roughly 10,000 credits per minute. Next up is the World Rally Challenge at Alsace, good for 750,000 credits per hour. While we're not huge fans of the game's rally physics at the moment, this race takes rally cars and puts them onto tarmac at the Alsace Village Circuit, unlocked at Menu Book number 6. You can actually use any car you like here, so long as it meets the 700 PP limit and has racing tires. That means many Group 4s will qualify, as will Group 3 machinery with a decent handicap, and with great downforce comes great lap times. The event is worth 75,000 credits with the clean race bonus, and you'll be able to fly through it in under 6 minutes in the right car for a solid 12,500 credits per minute. Next, we have Clubman Cup Plus at Goodwood, which will earn you around 850,000 credits per hour. Although certainly not the best method, this particular way of earning cash has the benefit of being unlocked very early in the game. The Goodwood Motor Circuit unlocks at Menu Book number 2. Although it's ranked as a 4 chili event, it's not particularly challenging even if you don't lower the general difficulty, as we suggested earlier. The payout is 52,500 credits if you earn that juicy clean race bonus. You should be finishing the 2-lap event in approximately 3 minutes and 40 seconds, and skipping through the menus quickly will net you around 14,000 credits per minute. Next up is the GT Cup Group 4 at High Speed Ring, good for 875,000 credits per hour. If you don't want to deal with the rally stages, this race for 630 PP Group 4 cars is the most efficient and probably the easiest to deal with. High Speed Ring might be a fan favorite, but it's not complicated, and there's not many places to screw things up here. It unlocks early at menu book number 3, and you can grab a Group 4 Supra for free as a reward for scoring gold in every International B license test. The race here matches the top event on our list for raw payout at 97,500 credits with the clean race bonus. However, at 5 laps, it will take you longer to complete, with around 6 minutes and 45 seconds between race starts. That still offers a solid payout of over 14,000 credits per minute. Finally, we have the Dirt Champions event at Fisherman's Ranch, good for an incredible 1.75 million credits per hour. The most effective method of all right now for credits is also one of the weirdest. You'll need to unlock the Fisherman's Ranch Rally Circuit by completing menu book number 36. You should also have a Group B rally car, which you can win from either menu book number 37 or with an International License A. With that done, apply some dirt tires and get to work. This event is rated at 3 chilies in difficulty, but there is no performance point limit, so you can go crazy with tuning if you want. The race scores you 97,500 credits with the clean race bonus, and most importantly, it's only a single lap event. If you're fast, it's possible to complete the race in less than 3 minutes and 20 seconds. That equates to almost 30,000 credits per minute of racing, and if you're quick enough, through the menus, 1.75 million credits an hour. Once again, these are the fastest ways to earn credits in the game at launch, but we expect GT7 will receive many updates throughout its lifespan. Be sure to click on the top link in the description of this video to read our full article on the subject, which we will keep up to date as the game evolves. If you found this video useful, as always, be sure to like, subscribe, and visit our site at www.gtplanet.net for the latest on Gran Turismo 7 and all the racing games we cover.